Meghan Markle and Prince Harry parted ways for the second leg of their Africa tour on Wednesday. Harry is currently in Angola, where he is tracing his mother Princess Diana's footsteps and visiting a landmine clearance charity. Where is Meghan Markle today? Prince Harry, 35, paid a touching homage to his mother during his trip to Angola today. He visited the Halo Trust in Huambo, which Princess Diana first visited more than two decades ago. Meghan Markle stayed behind in South Africa with baby Archie, while Harry makes solo trips to three more southern African countries. But what is the Duchess of Sussex up to today? The Duke of Sussex marked a historic moment today as he followed in his mother's footsteps and recreated an iconic photo of Princess Diana in 1997. The Princess of Wales shook the world when she donned protective gear and walked through a minefield in Angola to raise awareness around unexploded mines. Prince Harry followed suit today before making a trip to the Huambo Orthopedic Center, which he renamed in honor of Princess Diana. He is to be a witness of how much of an impact Diana's campaign has had on Angola, as a field previously filled with unexploded landmines is now alively stressing with shops, schools and houses. Prince Harry is also to visit, just like his mother did, Huambo Orthopedic Center, which he will rename after his mother in honor of Princess Diana. For all the careful choreography in front of the cameras yesterday, this was not a photo opportunity. It was a homage. The Duke of Sussex had come to Angola to pay tribute to one of his late mother's most enduring achievements, tipping the balance in favor of a worldwide ban on landmines. "It has been an honor to retrace my mother's steps today," he said, touring the town where she first drew global attention to this issue in 1997. "I lost her 22 years ago, but the memory of her is with me daily and her legacy lives on." Prince Harry is not only visiting the same places in Angola that Princess Diana did, he's also meeting the same people who made an impact on her. During his visit to the city of Huambo on Friday, Harry, 35, stopped at the Princess Diana Orthopedic Center, the African hospital that his mother visited back in 1997, which has since been renamed after her. While there, the Duke of Sussex was introduced to landmine victim Sandra Thijika. Though their meeting may have appeared to be a typical encounter, it was much more special than what initially meets the eye. More than two decades before meeting the prince, Sandra famously shared a moment with Diana under a fig tree at an orthopedic workshop as a 13-year-old girl. The pair were captured sitting beside each other as Diana, then 36, placed her hand on Sandra's shoulder. Now, a 35-year-old woman with a prosthetic leg to help her get around, Sandra couldn't help but smile as Harry shook her hand and later, knelt down beside her chair to chat with her on Friday. Sandra wasn't the only person that Harry interacted with while visiting the site. The royal also met with another landmine victim, Justina Caesar, who lost her leg at 3 years old, as well as a number of young patients that he spent time with and watched as they received treatment from the center. Besides getting to know the patients, Harry toured the facilities and met the Minister for Health, the Director of Orthopedic Center and a representative of BP, which has donated equipment. Following a recent renovation, the hospital aims to become Angola's National Center of Excellence in Orthopedic Care. The Duke will remain in Angola for two more days, before traveling to Malawi where he will stay until October 1. The Duchess and their son Archie, meanwhile, are remaining in Cape Town for the time being, and they will move to Johannesburg next week to reunite with Prince Harry. While Meghan and Harry remain firmly at each other's sides for the first part of the tour, they now have separate schedules. This royal tour marks the Sussexes' first trip as a family as they brought baby Archie Harrison along with them. The four-month-old stole the show when he joined his parents to meet South African legend Archbishop Desmond Tutu on Wednesday. New mum Meghan attended engagement solo following Harry's departure for Botswana on Wednesday afternoon. However, today she is understood to be enjoying a day of rest with little Archie. According to the royal tour schedule released by House Sussex ahead of the Africa trip, Meghan will enjoy some days off before returning to royal engagements on Tuesday. On Tuesday, the Duchess will attend a roundtable discussion with the Association of Commonwealth Universities in Johannesburg. She will discuss challenges faced by young women in accessing higher education. Megan will also visit a local school to meet a charity that tackles sexual violence in schools. On the 10th and final day of their jam-packed tour, Harry and Meghan will reunite to meet with young inspirational young South Africans in Johannesburg communities. They will then meet with Graca Michelle, widow of the former president, Nelson Mandela. To wrap up the tour, the Duke and Duchess will meet with South African President Cyril Ramaphosa and his wife, Dr. Tshepo Motsepe. The family will head back to London that evening. While the Duke has a few days packed with events ahead of him, the palace hasn't announced any engagement to be carried out by Meghan today. Yesterday, the Duchess hosted a private breakfast with women working in public offices.